Anybody want to fist pump me?
I'm good for her right now. We're going to talk about a different kind of energy. Psychic medium Matt Fraser is here. Everyone experiences some form of negativity in their life. We all have those days where you're like, I can't believe, and it gets under your skin. But you're here to tell us how to cope with positive thinking. We hear a lot about it.
Yeah.
It really works. It can actually change our day, right? You're telling us how to do this.
Absolutely. So everybody is capable of creating positive thoughts within your life. And positive thinking is a lifestyle. You know, everybody wants to feel good and feel uplifted when you start your day and start the morning, but there's steps that you can take to create happiness within your life. And not only that, but there's things that you can do to turn a negative situation into something positive, because we all have those experiences where we don't want to get up in the morning, you know, to go to work, or, you know, we're dreading the day that's ahead, or, you know, maybe we're nervous because we have a little bit of conflict at someone at the office or someone that we work with or someone that we see. But one of the things is that life is too beautiful to have, bad days. You can have bad, you're allowed to have bad moments, but bad days, no. There's always something that you can do to change that around. So, for example, in the morning, if you're one of those people who can't get out of bed, who you're struggling in the morning, try downloading an app that plays music with your alarm clock, waking up in the morning with something positive, a positive song, or, you know, maybe that song Happy by Pharrell, or things like that to really jumpstart your morning. It's all about changing your thoughts. It's changing your thoughts around and the different patterns, because sometimes in life we get in those different patterns where you just think, you know, something's going to be a drag, or you just have some preconceived thoughts that you are carrying with you, and then things turn out not so bad at all. So it's turning those thoughts around, those patterns around.
But then, you know, I often try to do that, and then the good thought will be there for 2 seconds, and then all of a sudden the bad thought starts creeping back in. And it starts creeping back in. What do? Do you just turn that off? Would you just talk to yourself?
You always look for the silver lining. It's the same thing when you have someone at work or that you're dealing with every day that you might not see eye to eye with. One of the things that you can do is when you walk into the workplace, so when you're around that person, offer that person a compliment. And the reason why is not only, and you have to be sincere about it, it's not something that you make up, comment, you know, oh, I like your tie, I like your shirt, I like what you're wearing. And the reason why is it's going to train yourself to start seeing that person more in a positive light.
Your mom told you, kill them with kindness. I guess find one good thing, right?
Then when you see that person smile back at you and you start to engage in a positive conversation, it starts off your day with that person in a positive light. It allows you to see them happy and, you know, hopefully accepting the compliment. And then not only that, but it's going to allow you to, when you meet that person again, to think start to think positively about that person.
So when we're stressed out, you say we can also ask for help from our departed loved ones, and that actually comes to us.
Absolutely. I feel like that our departed loved ones are with us 24/7, and one of the things that they want us to know is to live a positive life here. Every challenge or every stressful situation that we go through is actually a life lesson, and that's one of the things that you can think about, Scott, is that, you know, in the middle of a struggle or a challenge or whatnot, think about what you're learning. Think about the lesson behind it. Maybe it's that if you're having issues with a coworker, that you're learning how to cope better with people. I feel like that every single thing that we learn here, like, because Earth to me is the classroom. Mm. It's where we learn our greatest life lessons before we take off to go to the other side.
So when you're having negative times, say, okay, what do I need to learn from this? So that doesn't keep repeating.
Right, absolutely. And one of the things is, like I said, starting the day off with a positive thought. One of the things that you can do is end the night with a positive thought as well. Even just thoughts of gratitude, thoughts of being thankful and kindness is going to help you to not only go to sleep ending on a positive note, but then also waking up on a positive note.
Your Foxwoods event is sold out, but if you want to go see Matt Fraser, you want to have a reading or learn more about how to be positive in your life, Monday, October 5th, Radisson Hotel in Hartford, 6:30 to 8:30 p.m. We're going to have the link on Better CT. It's $40. You can go, and a lot of people can get read there.
Yep. I'm going to be doing a group audience reading and reconnecting as many people I can with their loved ones on the other side.
That's fantastic. I'm looking forward to that.
And we have an offer. Two tickets to three. This is a six-ticket giveaway, so two tickets to three people. And so why don't you email us to mail@betterct.com to win these tickets and tell us something you do to change your mood when you're feeling negative.
All right.
We can all learn something. Thank you so much. We're back with psychic medium Matt Fraser, who's giving us tips on how to stay positive. And now he's going to do a reading. Always interesting to see this right on the air. Shannon Murphy, one of our summer interns, happened to be in the Better Connecticut audience today, and you got picked. So you ready for this? Have you ever had a psychic reading before?
I have not. so this should be fun.
She's a little nervous.
And Matt's like, meantime, I've got people who are waiting to talk to you.
Right, and I get so excited because no matter where I go, it's like I automatically sense and feel spirit when I'm in a room. And I actually felt your grandfather step forward. So is he the most recently departed?
Yes, so, in my family.
Perfect, because he just stepped forward and told me that his granddaughter was here, and he actually leaned down and kissed you to let you know that he's so excited to be here with all of you. His fondest moments with you were actually when you were just a little girl, because he remembers you being in the hospital and the first time that he actually held you, because he's showing me the pictures. Do you actually have the pictures of him holding you, like, as a child?
Yeah, I do, actually, at home.
So know that that's one of the things that he's reminding me that you had kept, and more importantly, he's telling me about how close he was to you here in this physical world. He's telling me all these different names of people that he's connecting with. Do you understand John?
Yeah.
Who's that?
He is one of my uncles.
Okay. So, and then he's also bringing me to Kathy as well?
Okay.
Who's that?
That is a cousin of mine also.
Okay. Because he's bringing me to all these people, like, as I'm connected with him, he's going, Paul, Kathy, this one, that one. Do you understand Paul as well?
Yeah.
Okay. So he's naming all your family members, because what I try to do is I try to give you validation that not only it's them, but I ask them for information that nobody else would know so that they're there and that they're with you. And so that you have the validation and gift of knowing that your grandfather's with you at all times. He also showed me a dog that recently departed that's with him on the other side.
Oh, really?
Do you understand the lab?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So know that he's there with us. You just get to. She's like so shocked right now. Know that, because he just welcomed the dog into his arms, him acknowledging that that dog is there and with him. He has told me that before he had left this world that there was issues going on within his chest. Do you understand? Mm-hmm. Because I had felt when I was connecting with him, like, it's almost like I can't breathe. And he had shown me that one of the things is that he didn't realize, like, when they show me that they, like, are diagnosed with something and something else happens. Do you understand? Meaning, like, I feel like there was either infections that were going on at the time or that there was issues going back and forth to the hospital. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
His way of acknowledging to you that he doesn't have illness anymore and that he is okay. He said to me that at the end that you had felt like you didn't get to talk to him, or you had felt as though that he couldn't respond back to you. And one of the things that he had said to me was about the fact that he's been with you your entire life. He says, don't worry about me. He says, I am fine. He sends you birds all the time, by the way. Like, do you ever, that's his symbol with you. So for example, one of the things that he had shown me is that he was an outdoors person when he was here in this physical world, because I keep seeing him, like, fishing and doing all of these things that he loved and he enjoyed. And he'd shown me that when you see birds, or when you just have a random bird that won't leave you alone, or that just flies out in front of you, that's your grandfather's way of acknowledging that he's there and that he's with you and safe and at peace.
Oh, wow.
And he also showed me, was he 80 when he passed?
He was.
Because he just told me his age, acknowledging about the fact that he was so happy that he got to live a ripe life, got to live older here in this physical world, and that he's so proud of you on the other side. He had told me about the fact that you always used to be into drawing or pictures or things like that, because he's also pulling you into photography as well, and telling you that it's really important that you go with it, because there's a lot of hidden talents that you haven't even uncovered yet that he's pushing you for on the other side.
That's so cool. Thank you.
You're very welcome.
Wow. I mean, those were a lot. That was very accurate, right? All those names were right. Everything? Was everything just spot on?
It's pretty accurate.
As far as, like, how I talk so quickly is that when I get the information, it's like I just can't even control myself. It's like one thing after another. As fast as I'm talking to her is as fast as the information comes to me on the other side. And that's what it's like for me at a live event as well, is that when I'm out in the audience with people, one time I even got to read 70 people in the audience, because it's like,
so
go,
fast.
Go, 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 go.
So if you want to be one of those people, you have a live event coming up Monday, October 5th, Radisson Hotel, Hartford, 6:30 to 8:30. We'll have details on betterct.com. Cost is only $40
to attend. An update is that all of my events are kept to a limited audience. So Foxwoods is already sold out. So if you are planning on tickets, make sure that you get them early.
Okay. All right. Wow. All right. Thank you, Matt. And Shannon, we'll have to talk later. That was pretty interesting. Yeah. All right.